wanna clap those hands if you know he's been good to you. Oh, yeah. We praise you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. We worship you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. We praise you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. We worship you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
This is the way.
This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap your hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap your hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
We praise you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. We worship you, oh Lord. We magnify your name. Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
Everybody,
clap your hands.
This is the way.
This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap your hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you.
Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands. Lifting our voice.
Singing our song.
Singing our song.
Praising the Lord. Clap your hands.
Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you. Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you. Clap your hands. This is the way we praise you. Clap your
hands. Our call to worship today comes from 1 Chronicles 16. The Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and gladness are in his place. Give to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Give to the Lord glory and strength. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Spirit washed in This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my side. Angels descending, bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior and happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.
Our scripture reading today is taken from 2 Samuel chapter 6, verses 12 through 17. 2 Samuel 6, 12 through 17. Now it was told King David, saying, "The Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that belongs to him because of the ark of God." So David went and brought up the ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom to the city of David with gladness. And so it was, when those bearing the ark of the Lord had gone six paces, that he sacrificed oxen and fatted sheep. Then David danced before the Lord with all his might, and David was wearing a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. Now as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, Saul's daughter, looked through a window and saw King David's leaping and whirling before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart. So they brought the ark of the Lord and set it in its place in the midst of the tabernacle that David had erected for it. Then David offered burnt offerings and peace offerings before the Lord. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and understanding of his word. This is Pastor Prince, and we are so delighted for you to be here worshiping with us today. Here during this year that we're celebrating our 150th anniversary. And if you are visiting our online worship service for the first time, we would love to hear more about you. Please join our Facebook page, Mount Calvary Church, Orangeburg, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Mount Calvary, Orangeburg. If you would like for us to contact you directly, please send your contact information to us by instant message or email us at mountcalvary3365@yahweh.com. You are always welcome to join us here online and to join us in person as we resume our services. Praise the Lord, saints. Our youth had a wonderful, wonderful talent night, virtual talent night yesterday. We thank them and the leadership, Sister Fulmore and Dr. Stevens, for working on that with our young people, and they all did such a great job. We want to remind you that next week, in addition to our online service, we'll be having a drive-in service, which will include communion. Today we celebrate our fifth Sunday of the month, a bonus Sunday for this month, and we'll be blessed with the word given to us by Reverend Johnson. And Reverend Johnson will also be bringing back our prayer meetings on Thursday nights at 7. Look for the phone number to dial in to our prayer meetings on Thursday, led by Reverend Johnson. We want to thank God for being with our sick and shut-in, and we want to ask your continued prayers for them, for those who are in our congregation, in our community, and especially for Sister Gordon, Deacon Jennings' sister. We just want to pray their health and strength. Continue to keep your eyes open and ears open as we're being a little bit more vigilant as we're being asked to be regarding the virus and the new strains that are here in this country and specifically in South Carolina, and also about getting vaccinated. If there's anyone who wishes to get a vaccine and doesn't have transportation or there's some obstacles to you receiving that vaccine, please give us a call at the church or give your deacon a call, and we will do whatever we can to help facilitate in you receiving that vaccine. Bible study continues, and we started a little early with a Bible study on the African presence in Scripture. Very excited about this, and I pray you all are listening and learning for Black History Month about how we can see our face in the faith. So tune in to the Bible study from last week and the several weeks coming as we look at the African presence in Scripture. And again, we're going to be having a new system, a calling system to everyone. So make sure that the church has your updated mobile number and home number as well. If you're going to be taking notes for the Scripture today and studying, you can mark down these scriptures: Psalm 34, 2 Samuel 6, and 2 Chronicles 20, 15 through 18. Continuing our worship through giving, 2 Corinthians 9, 6 through 8 says, "Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a what? A cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Let us pray. Dear Lord, thanking you and loving you for the gifts that have been presented to you at Mount Calvary. We thank you that you will create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us to be able to be good stewards over all these resources, not just for our community of faith, but for the entire community of Orangeburg and South Carolina. Lord God, we love you and thank you and ask you to bless the families of those who are able to give and bless those who desire to give but had not. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, I try so hard to be the best that I can be. It's like every time I take one step, something's right in front of me. Lord, where would I be without your grace and mercy, Lord? Now I have one question. Heading out of control, somehow it shifted into overload. But then you came and did a work in. After everything I once was, somehow you saw my masterpiece. Couldn't let me out of this maze. And what you saw in me, I didn't know. But Lord, I'm glad that you saw it. And every piece of me that was a mystery. For the rest of my life, I'll never know why you made something out of nothing.
Good morning, church family. I pray and trust that your week was enjoyable, family members are fine, and God was just so good to you. not just this week or this day or this month, but every time you think of his goodness, you have a praise that you just can't keep to yourself. Our text this morning is coming from Psalms 34 and 1. Psalms 34 and 1. And it reads, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. Dear Father, I now ask that you remove AJ, Adrian, Rev, minister out the way, and let you come forth. In the mighty name of Jesus, I do pray. Amen. For the time that is ours together, I want to preach from the subject, praise is what I do. Praise is what I do. I will begin this message by setting the tone by admitting to you that this message is not for the radical praisers. No, this message is not for those who come to church or tune in to this broadcast just to sit cool and collected. This message is not for those who simply don't like a whole lot of praise or a whole lot of noise. However, this message is for those that would be honest enough to admit that there have been times in your lives when we just had to praise our way through. This message is for those who have come to the conclusion and realization in our lives that no matter how bad it gets, I made up in my mind that I will bless the Lord at all times. This message is for those who don't care how folks look at you, and you certainly don't care how they criticize you when you get excited about what God has done in your life. Matter of fact, you've gotten to the point, the more they look, the more you praise. The more they talk about you, the louder you get. You see, nobody knows like you know what the Lord has done for you. You wasn't there when he paid my bills when I didn't have a dime in my pocket. You wasn't there when he delivered me from that bad habit. No, you wasn't there when God made sure I had a car to drive, food to eat, a roof over my head, or clothes on my back. You wasn't there when he healed my body and made a way out of no way. So surely I'm not going to let you dictate my praise. As a matter of fact, I'm just getting happy just thinking about how good God has been to me. And I'm wondering if there's anybody out there that's listening that feels like I do this morning. For some of you, the reason you tune in this morning is because the Lord has just been too good for you to just not to. See, I don't need a whole lot of music. I don't need the right song or the right preacher. All I got to do is start thinking, and I'll begin to start thanking him for the many storms he's brought me through. Can you think about that one thing that you know it was only the Lord that could have done this for you? If so, you couldn't be sitting quiet right now in your house. But if you can't think of anything, let me help you just for a second. You see, last night he laid you down. He watched over you all night. He woke you up this morning, as my grandparents would say, and clothed you in your right mind. He put food on your table, put clothes on your back. Your health seemed to be pretty good. That's praise in and of itself. 3 points I want to give to you, and I'll be out of your way. Point one. If you are going to be an authentic praiser, your praise has to be volunteer. You see, notice the text says, I will. Whether anybody else does it or not, I will. Now, I pray that the Lord deliver us from those people who got to be pumped up, prime up, and got to get ready to hear the right preacher in order to bless the Lord. Listen, as soon as you think about what God has done for you, you ought to want to give him the praise. You ain't got to say my favorite cliche. You ain't got to come on and praise the Lord. As soon as I walk into church, matter of fact, if you catch me in Walmart sometimes or driving to work, I'll stop and give God a praise right there because he's been too good for me. Your praise has to be voluntary. Nobody should have to usher you into the praise. Nobody should have to suggest to you to praise. You ought to want to praise him after everything he's done for you. Not only must praise be voluntary, Secondly, praise must be visual. There is no such thing as a sit-down, non-showing praise. That's the reason I just can't understand how we can go to a football game and our team scores a touchdown or make a bad play, and we are at the top of our lungs, but we come to church and just sit quiet. Sit like a knot on the log. Every now and then you ought to lift your hands. Every now and then you need to stomp your feet. Every now and then you need to clap your hands, leap for joy, just do something. You ought to let the world see through your praise what God has done for you. When we were in elementary school, we used to sing this nursery rhyme that if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, turn yourself around, and then it will get good to you. If you're happy and you know it, do all three. Never did it suggest if you're happy and you know it, just sit there, be quiet, and do nothing. It says if you're happy and you know it, do something. And I don't wait until I'm out of a problem to praise the Lord, but I like to confuse the enemy while I'm still struggling and straining. I'm going to praise him because I know the praise precedes my breakthrough. So praise got to be voluntary, praise got to be visual, and finally, praise must be vocal. In other words, you got to open up your mouth. Notice that the scripture says, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. And I'm wondering if there's anybody out there listening to me this morning who just can open up their mouth in your homes, in your car, wherever you're listening at this current time, and just open up your mouth and testify to yourself about how good God has been to you. And you don't care if the car next to you looking, you don't care if your whole house just got up and looking at you like you're crazy, but you still going to get that praise in. Well, as always, I can't speak for you, but I can speak about Adrian. See, I praise him because early this morning he woke me up. He started me on another day's journey. As I look around, my phone didn't ring, or as I look around, I kind of research and observe and scan, all my family was doing fine. So many times he was my bridge over troubled waters. When I didn't know how I was going to pay my bills, he supplied all, not some, but all my needs. So many times he was my Jehovah Jireh, my Jehovah Nisi. He's my mind regulator, my heart fixer. When I should have lost my mind, he kept me. When doors were closed in my face, he opened doors that no man could shut. When folks talked about me, lied on me, called me everything but a child of God, he prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You see, there was a time that I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peace for sure. Very deeply stained within, I was sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea, he heard my despairing cry, and from the waters he lifted me. Now safe am I. I got a reason to praise him. Blessed assurance, surely Jesus is mine. Or what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. I'm born of his spirit, and I'm washed in his blood. You see, this is my story. This is my song, and I'm going to praise the Lord all my day long. Now, before I leave you, I just want to talk to you just for a minute about a story I'm reminded of about a boy named Bobby. Oh, I like the story of Bobby because Bobby knew how to praise God, and it was just because God was good. See, Bobby was a 19-year-old teen, and he worked in a steel mill, and every morning before he would begin work, he would say, "Good morning, Jesus. This is Bobby, and I just want to thank and praise you for waking me up this morning with a reasonable portion of health and strength. Jesus, I praise you because you died for my sins, and for that, I thank you." Now, his co-workers would look at him like he was totally crazy. They would laugh, and they would talk, and They would just get behind him and whisper. But that didn't stop Bobby in his praise. Because there were times when Bobby would get happy. Bobby would stop leaping for joy, running around and yelling to the top of his voice. Now, you know they really thought he was crazy. But one day, the steel mill caught on fire and everybody had to evacuate the building. Come on now, help me. As they began to do a count, they noticed somebody was missing. Soon they realized they were missing Bobby. But by this time, the building was consumed with smoke. And the building was beginning to fall to the ground. Everyone began to cry at this point for Bobby. They started hugging and, you know, oh my God, if I realized. But somebody yelled out, go get Bobby's mama and tell her that Bobby didn't make it out. He didn't make it through the fire. He didn't make it through the storm. But there in the midst of all the rumble and through the smoke, here come Bobby. Lord, help me tell it. They were amazed at what they were seeing. They began to ask Bobby, how did you survive this fire? Bobby said, I was at my station and all of a sudden I was surrounded by smoke and the building was falling. Just when I thought I was about to die, just when I thought I couldn't last another second, I remember my mama and my grandmama and they taught me Psalm 23. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, I heard a voice say, hello, Bobby. This is Jesus. All I'm trying to say to you, my Mount Calvary family, that if you have a firm foundation with this Jesus, you can praise him in the midst of any storm, and he'll come through. Won't he do it? Just ask yourself, won't he do it? I'm not going to wait till the battle is over to start praising him. I'm going to praise him while I'm going through that battle. So every time you think that you can't make it another second, just think about the goodness of the Lord, and you start giving him your praise right then, and watch God. Watch him. Watch God work it out. Praise is what I do. I thank you for this moment that we had together, and I hope that something I may have said to you will encourage you to go forth this week, next month, because with a praise, you can get through anything. Praise is what I do.
Church, I learned to worship. send the praise to the nation. Somebody send the praise to Africa. Somebody send the praise to China.
Praise is what I do.
Open up your mouth, church. Something is wrong with him. Doesn't he know? We don't act like that in our church. Doesn't John know? We've got dignitaries in our church. We're going. We're going to John's house. Well, when they got out there, old 86-year-old man, him and an old beat-up mule plowing. Plowing in the field. They drove all of the deacons. They got out of their fine cars. They walked over to John. John looked around and said, "Whole mule." Walked over to him and said, "Brethren, I know why you've come out here. You've come out here to tell me that I praise the Lord too much. You've come out here to tell me that I dance too much." One of the deacons told him, "If you don't stop shouting, if you don't stop dancing, they're going to put you out of our church." Somebody say, "Well, put me out. I can't
hold my peace. Did you see all of that land you just drove up on? He said, God gave me all that land. But you don't want me to dance in your church. Said, look at my sons and daughters. Said, God gave me all of my children. Not one time have I been to the courthouse. Not one time have I been to the cemetery. But you don't want me to dance in your church. Then he said, look at me. I'm 86 years old. I'm still able to walk down behind that old mule. I'm still able to harvest my own crop. But you don't want me to dance in your church. Listen, Brother Deacons, if I can't shout in your church, hold my mule. I'm going to shout right here. That's the way I feel right now. I feel like old Shawn John. I know we got some dignified folk in here, but I come to tell you, I feel like praising him.
Praise the Lord. We thank Reverend Johnson again for that wonderful message for the three V's of praise, that it is to be voluntary, it is to be visual, and it is to be vocal. Know that we want to praise God when things are going well, but it's most profound and most appreciated by God when we praise Him even in the midst of the flames and the fire and the trouble. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for you have given us the victory and that we don't need to wait till the battle is over, but we can shout a praise to you right now. We learn from your children past, as with Joshua, when the walls came tumbling down on Jericho through a loud shout of praise. Lord God, help us to be voluntarily praising every day, to be praising visually every day, and to praise vocally every day. We ask all this in Jesus' name. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you and make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you and give you peace. Henceforth, now and forevermore, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us all say, Amen.